growing up in the sort of mid-70s with the publicity around the moon landing, so I wanted to be an astronaut very early on, and then that shaded into more scientific approach that kept my feet on the ground. I've been continuing my research into nearby galaxies that orbit the Milky Way, so it's our home galaxy. And one of the things that's become really interesting over the past few years is the idea that we can find the first stars that formed in the universe by basically taking their chemical fingerprint. There should be sort of a first generation of stars that has only the elements that were present at the Big Bang. And if any of those stars have survived to the present time, they should be recognizable by that kind of spectroscopic chemical fingerprint, which will, if we can discover that population of stars, will tell us a lot about the early universe and about how stars produce chemical elements, leading ultimately to the distribution of things that we see today on Earth and in the solar system. So I've had a PhD student working on understanding how the elements have been cooked in stars, if you like, over 14 billion years within the Milky Way and other nearby galaxies. So the technology we used to search for planets around other stars was actually, the theory was worked out by Einstein in 1916. And he said if his theory of gravity and general relativity was true, that this effect should exist. But he said there's no practical way it could ever be observed. Of course, he didn't have a worldwide network of telescopes with digital cameras, which could take a million images at a time. University is unique in Australia in having a large amount of telescopes accessible to the use of the staff and students. And our latitude and longitude make us really well placed to join international collaborations. So our group, for example, works with astronomers in South Africa and South America so that we have 24-hour continuous coverage of the southern skies. And the southern skies are quite a bit more interesting than the northern skies, just purely by coincidence. That's where the central parts of our galaxy happen to be located. So we have a clear and unobstructed view of those.